this is how we add decimals. First of all, we should probably know what a decimal means. If this is 15.3467, this 1 is in the tens place, the 5 is in the ones place, the 3 is in the tenths place, the 4 is in the hundredths place, the 6 is in the thousandths place, the 7 is in the 10,000ths place. If we're going to add decimals together, we have to make sure that we add things together that are alike. So we're going to add tenths to tenths, hundredths to hundredths, ones to ones, tens to tens, and so forth. That's why when we add decimals, we line up the decimal points so that the numbers will be in the correct place. So we need to know that first of all. Next, you should know that all addition and subtraction, for that matter, is done vertically. Even though the problem may be presented to you horizontally, and you may want to do it horizontally, you should set the problem up vertically. Setting up vertically ensures that you will do it successfully. Now you also need to know that if a number has no decimal point, you will find it at the end, period. Just like a period at the end of a sentence. So if you have a number like 12, it's 12.0. So you need to know that or else you can't line up the decimal points. So let's take a typical example. Say 12 plus 3.2 plus 0 plus 0.078. You don't need the initial zero there in front of the decimal point. You can put it in if you feel like it to make it clear to you. So here we need to line things up that are alike. We need the numbers in the tenths place all lined up together and so forth. So here we have a 12. A 12 has no decimal point, so we find it at the end. So we have 12.3.2. We're going to line up the decimal points like so. And 0.078. Then we put our line, then we can put an addition sign to remind us that we're actually adding. Now you can fill in these zeros if you feel like it. You don't really need to. If you fill them in, I'll put it in a slightly different color here. If you fill them in, it may help you to organize your thoughts and to keep track of where the numbers are supposed to go. So I could put these zeros in here. It might make it clearer and easier to do the problem. Now we can simply add it up as if it's a normal, ordinary addition of whole numbers. So we add here, we get an 8, 7, 2, the decimal point, very important where it goes, 3 and 2 is 5, bring down the 1, so 12 plus 3.2 plus 0.78 is 15.278, 15 and 278 thousandths. Let's try another example. So let's try another typical example, 7.6 plus 4.98 plus 7. So I start out, I line up the decimal points, I'm going to do it vertically, I have 4.98, then I have 7, but of course it's a whole number, it has no decimal point, I'm going to find it at the end. So I have 7. Now I can take and put in my addition sign, change the color here again. This is optional. You can put the zeros in if you feel like it to help you organize your thoughts here. So here we have added up, we have 8, 6 and 9 is 15, decimal point, carry the 1, 7 and 1 is 8, and 4 is 12, and 7 is 19. So 7.6 plus 4.98 plus 7 is 19.58, 19 and 58 hundredths. And that's about all there is to how to add decimals. Happy computing.
I hope you learned how to add decimals. I also hope you enjoyed the film. Thank you.